All right, a little bit of a fumble turning off that music, but how is it going, everybody? My name is Trips. My buddy Walrus is getting some water, so he will join us in just a second. And this is going to be round four of the losers bracket. We're going to see 1UP Roma versus Ossini in pajamas, or very bad players in pajamas, which I'm told. I don't know if that's true, but that is what I have been told. And I also told that Twitch is already muting my VODs, even though the playlist that I'm using on YouTube says that it's free. I can use it in my VODs, but Twitch decides, no, it's not free. You're lying. But I'll get that sorted out, hopefully. And right now we're going to see a couple bans coming out. Leshrac being banned out for 1UP Roma. Maybe that's a respect ban. Maybe they were watching their last game. I do not know. But we're also going to see a Razor ban out, as well as the Undying for the Dire, and, you know, usual bans. Razor, not so much usual. He can be very strong, very, very strong, but I haven't seen Razor be too incredible. Okay. How's it going?
Fine.
Okay. I want to check your audio level on to make sure that... Okay. I'll turn it up just a little bit. If it gets too loud, I'll turn it down. But, like I said, here, I'm going to give you this. There's that for you if you want it. That is the bracket. Right now, we are in round four of losers. So, let's see. Where are we at? Winner of this game will face the winner of 60 Cooler versus Elemental Seth. And that is going to be... Is that quarters yet? No.
Looks like that is the quarterfinals.
For losers.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, quarterfinals for losers. Alright, Bristleback being picked up here. Very strong offlaner. I feel like... Have they changed much about Bristle since they released him?
I actually hate Bristleback as an offlaner on this patch. I think it's awful, honestly.
Really? What about as a position one?
I think as a position one, he is situationally okay. As long as you have other minus armor on your team, I think he does really well.
So if you had like a dazzle,
startup time, great survivability in lane. As long as you have anything else with you, I think offlane dual lane he's okay. Solo lane he has a lot of issues. If they pick a strong zoning support, he has absolutely no answer to it. He can't actually fight other support heroes like a lot of other heroes, like even that Tidehunter or even Centaur to a certain extent because he has return. Bristleback doesn't have any options to really fight the support heroes. They just pick up a stick. Even if they don't pick up a stick, they're still attacking him from the front when he's trying to go on. So it's very difficult for him to make effective trades like that.
Okay. Seeing an HR operation Shadow Demon, that's really odd to me. I feel like Shadow Demon's usually picked up for as a setup, but he did get buffed a little bit recently with the Shadow Poison mana cost, I believe, reduced.
You can set up Cold Feed, too.
Oh, okay.
It's through the disruption, it still hits.
Oh, okay.
Which is really dumb and a really good combo. They definitely need another strong hero. Those heroes do good amounts of damage at levels 4 and 5, but early on they're going to have some issues with zoning this Bristleback, which in this case he would actually be okay. I think he does well against heroes that aren't able to constantly zone him. And these heroes don't have a lot of spells that are really going to do an insane amount of damage to them, other than Shadow Poison, he gets hit by a bunch of shimes, but...
More melee coming out from the Radiant.
I think that's okay. They definitely want to get a Rage Carry with Azurshaker here, though, and I find it surprising that they have picked it up after banning out Leshrac and Razor, both heroes, which I think do extremely well with Azurshaker.
Mm-hmm.
Especially Leshrac, so, I mean, I understand why they banned him, but it's a little odd to see him pick the Azurshaker up after that. One overlooked hero, Sniper, I think is still good with Azurshaker. I think he's a lot worse mid than he used to be, which is good for what the hero is. He doesn't dominate the mid lane as much as he used to, but still definitely an effective hero at farming, and once he gets a certain amount of items up, he is very good at, from a distance, tearing teams apart without them even getting close to him.
Mm-hmm. He definitely got a big nerf, but he's still... It's just kind of one of those, they're in popularity, and then once they get nerfed, everyone just completely overlooks them. They're just, people assume that they're just, you know, nerfed into the ground, but he's still a decent hero.
He just needs more startup time now. He used to be way too strong, and I definitely agree with the nerfs that he got, because it makes him basically a useless mid laner, which is good, because mm-hmm. he was supposed to be carrying. it's intended to be that way, and it's intended to need a lot of startup time to be an effective hero. So he definitely got the nerfs he deserved, but it's especially with the setup like Grishnik, I think he definitely needs some help, and that's a great hero for keeping people in and allowing him to do his damage even early on.
They're banning Raid Dire or banning out the Viper. Do you think they're going for anything mid specific? Because I don't think Viper stops Earthshaker or Bristleback too hard.
I think it's a very annoying hero against Ancient Apparition and Shadow Demon, especially. They don't really have an answer to him. They don't have good disables to kind of keep him out of fights, and they don't do any damage to him because they do purely magic damage, pretty much.
Okay.
So I think that's a good thing. It does open up the mid lane a lot more when you ban out, like, Razor and Viper. It opens up the mid lane to a lot more heroes that wouldn't ordinarily do okay against, like, a hard, you know, stopper like that. The Viper is basically a way of saying, well, I don't want anyone to win mid lane. We want to win mid lane. Viper doesn't do so great late game unless he has a huge farm advantage, but he is effective at making the mid lane a wash pretty much every time.
Okay. Nice ban out from the Lion. I feel like a Lion mixed up with that Earthshaker, and if they do run that with the Bristleback, that'll be decent tri lane, just all the stuns that you can bring out, and the CC and Bristleback able to just snot you up and tear you down. I don't know if it'd be amazing, but it's decent.
I think they are going to run the Bristleback offlane. I don't personally like it, but I think that a lot of people still value it as an offlane hero. It just needs a lot more help than the games that I'm used to, I think.
Mm-hmm.
The way that I draft personally is very sacrificial on the offlane, and the cons of the offlane to do a lot more early on, but some people don't play that way, so.
Can you even efficiently do Ancients as a Bristleback?
Efficiently, no. You can do them, but the problem is he's not Tidehunter. You need more than just level 5 to go do them. Tidehunter gets level 5, and he can do them slow, but he can do them effectively. You know, you can be there forever. Mm-hmm. He doesn't take any damage, and there's really no time limit on it as long as you have the vision up for it.
Heather Centaur being picked up. Centaur, obviously a very good offlaner, in my opinion, at least. He doesn't really need much besides Blink and Tranquils.
I think that's a great offlaner, this patch. He's been overlooked at a lot of high-tier games, I think, because he doesn't really offer a lot late game. He doesn't offer a lot in like the mid-to-late kind of area where a lot of heroes are starting to be really strong, like Olga Shrek or Queen of Pain or Storm of Spirit. He doesn't really offer a lot of options against heroes like that. But against teams that like to group up, he's very, very effective, and he's very good at making your whole team initiate. Instead of being kind of out on an island by himself and initiating, he can bring his whole team in, and they can all get in very quickly and do stuff, and he has great initiation against teams like to group up.
Okay. Ventral Spirit Raven picked up. She's good. She's nice right now, but I don't... they could go with the Luna here, but Luna might die to the Centaur, honestly. She's pretty squishy.
I don't think it's particularly great with the Ventral Spirit, but I don't think it's bad either. It's an okay pickup. They don't really have a lot of other options for, like, really, really strong supports this game. That they, if they want to have something more aggressive, and the Ventral Spirit can definitely roam with the Earthshaker and provide a lot to, like, a smoke gank or something like that, where they're going to gank mid effectively and move around the map. The double stun is just really nice. Earthshaker is a nice long-range stun to set up Ventral Spirit. It's a very short stun.
Mm-hmm.
Her stun is really effective. You just have to be able to get onto someone. So I think the Ventral Spirit, while her stun is good for setting up other heroes sometimes, she definitely can benefit from having a hero like that that can initiate before.
Jug pickup. Jug's going to be able to eat up Earthshaker and Venge if he can catch him out with an Omni Slash pretty early, actually.
I think he's actually pretty good against Bristleback, too. I think that, and I'm not totally sure on this mechanic, but I don't think you get the bonus from Bristleback when you get Omni Slash, or it's like random or something. I'm not really sure.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like it doesn't do as much as it should, even when you're facing away from where you like cast it or something.
If you Omni Slash and then Phantom Double walks, you completely lose that Omni, right?
Yep.
That is very unfortunate.
That's a good pickup. Even without doubling out of it, the illusion's great against Juggernaut unless he picks up an early Battle Fury, which is very ambitious build, definitely, for the Juggernaut. Mm-hmm. And not one that we see super often. They don't have a lot of options for dealing with the Phantom Lance for this game, unlike the Phantom Lance we saw last game. They have the Cleave from the Centaur and the Ancient Apparition, like I was saying last time, but they don't really have a lot of options for consistently killing his illusions, and he's going to have a good time as long as these heroes get levels. And they have kind of a potential issue in the fact that this Bristleback might just get ruined if he goes, like, I mean, obviously he's going offlane now, unless he's going mid, but he might just get ruined, honestly, if they just go on him consistently and they keep going on him over and over again.
What if they
if I was them, I'd honestly just, I think I might pick up Wisp and then send the Wisp and the Bristleback middle against whatever they're going to pick up, which is not going to be able to survive against that because they already banned out all the good mid heroes.
Yeah.
And then just run the Earthshaker off lane.
What if they picked up a Quaswex and Voker in this Dire?
On the Dire?
Mm-hmm.
I think he'd do effectively against whatever they pick. Both teams looking for a mid-hero, it seems.
Yeah.
Unless something odd happens, like I said, with like an IO or something like that. So both teams definitely looking to pick up a mid-hero, and there's not really a lot of really killer mid-heroes. I think Invoker is good. He's not like a top-tier pick, but definitely up there. They banned out a lot of the good, like, lots of mid-heroes, you know, the TA, the Quap, the Storm Spirit, the Viper, Razor even, Lashrak.
Yeah, four bans and two bans. So six mid-heroes being banned out so far. Jesus. That's a good pickup, Shadow Fiend. He actually completely went unnoticed there. Lina as well. Lina definitely wins this matchup if she's going to be going up against the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, I would think so. I have seen Shadow Fiends win that if Lina doesn't get aggressive enough early on, and you really need to play up in his face and do whatever you can to keep him down as early as possible, because he cannot hurt you at levels 1, 2, and 3, basically, unless he shits you with a triple raise, which, unless you have terrible spacing, you have 675 attack range, so that shouldn't really happen. But yeah, the Lina definitely had an advantage in that lane.
Alright, so let's go ahead and introduce the teams. Over on the Dire right now, we have OP, and that is going to contain Thieb on the answer, Ancient Apparition. Fuck this game. On the Shadow Fiend, Aux. On the Shadow Demon, Shadow Fae. On the Juggernaut, and Green Ghost on the Centaur Warrunner.
And over on the 1-up side on the Radiant, looks like they're going to have Intracranial Neoplasm on the Lina. Looks like she is going mid. It's going to be Zealot on the Bristleback going into the off lane. Asky on the Phantom Lancer farming in the short lane. And then Lattice on the Vengeful Spear going to the bottom lane. And Curly Trust, who is bringing up the rear with the Earthshaker. It's like, I don't know what he's doing. They might be going for a level 1 here. It's like they're going to try and stack up on the top rune and try and catch all the Shadow Fiend if they can, which would be a great pickup early on. But Dire definitely aware of this and stacking up heroes behind him as well. And they have good defensive supports here. That's not going to work.
I don't know if the Dire have enough to... I feel like with the disruption, they might be able to get out, but I don't think they win the fight.
No, they definitely don't win the fight, and I don't think they should try and take it. I think they lose the fight, but the Earthshaker might be able to get off a good stun here, but they are doing the right thing and coming from two directions on this. You don't know about the
and Shadow Fiend might die here easily. Yeah, definitely gonna...
That was very ambitious of him to run out there like that.
And could they get a kill on this Jug as well? Does someone else have a stun? Lightstrike a raise up, and it's gonna land.
That was not what they needed to do. Like you said, they can disengage from a fight like that if they have the uphill advantage, but running into that, I guess they didn't really know that the smoke was there because they couldn't see the heroes. Maybe they thought they backed up or something, but they definitely don't win that level 1 fight at all. So
they just lost both of their cores. Who did that go to? Bristle and Venge.
Oh, Venge got the other kill. They also got the
Shadow Fiend.
The Shadow Fiend, and he got the Bounty Rune.
So
he's already almost at level 2, which is very good for him, because now he has one level 1 Bristleback, and that early level 1 Bristleback is not to be underestimated. 16% damage reduction is great when you have 0 most of the time. He's already got a Ring of Protection, which means these support heroes are going to have a difficult time auto-attacking him down. So
now with this start, how do you feel about the Bristleback offlane?
It's great now. It's awesome as long as you can get off to a good start. Like I said, that's the main issue with heroes. If you get stuck at level 1 or level 2 for a long time, then you have issues. But they're not really going to apply a lot of pressure to him now. He's so far ahead already. He's almost level 3. He's already got a great lead on this Juggernaut, who's only 1.5 now and sharing experience with the AA. So now the Bristleback seems like a great pick because he got off to that great early start, got the Bounty Rune, and got some experience early on. The Bristleback should be getting more than the Centaur as long as they keep on the Centaur in bottom lane, because he has to be really afraid of the Earthshaker. He can't move up past like the line where down here where he can get killed by a fissure coming across and stuff like that, and they're just standing out here because they know that as long as the Centaur doesn't get experience, they're already winning because the Bristleback is doing well already.
Mm-hmm. Venja's taking a little bit of harass just from the return damage, but I don't know. Unfortunately, they did push up this lane, so Centaur's going to get a bit of experience. What's the difference right now?
They got two ranged creeps going now, so they, in lieu of pulling to kind of keep the Centaur out early, which I don't know if that's the best option. He's already level 3, but he will have kind of a rough, difficult time. Like I said, once the lane pushes back past the river, he can't really move up into it, otherwise he's at risk of dying. He doesn't have any getaways, he can get easily trapped in, and then have a bad time. The Shadowfiend is doing great, so he's lead on, that's what I was talking about. If he gets off to an early start, he can definitely stand up to her.
Set up on this Bristle right now, he actually might not make it out. I don't think he will. Nope. He's
done. That was very aggressive by him. I don't know that he needs to be making those kind of risks when he's already so far ahead. He doesn't need to be, you know, trying to pick up a bunch of levels already. He's almost level 4, he would have just stuck around in lane. He's still getting what he needs out of the lane. Now the Centaur is ahead of him, so he kind of threw away the early lead that he got handed to. Now Shadowfiend and Lina trading evenly in lane for now. Shadowfiend gonna power spike pretty hard, but the one problem with the Shadowfiend this game is that he's on the Dire side. Dire Shadowfiend is, it's okay. It does okay in the lane, but he doesn't have the same kind of options that he has when he's on the Radiant to go take, you know, the medium camp and stack stuff like that. He has to go all the way to the hard camp. The hard camp is obviously harder to take, so it takes him a little bit longer to get to it. And it takes more time out of the lane that he has to use to go up there and stack it, and also supports him more. So he should do okay, though. It looks like he's off to a really good start, and that's...
Up top, Bristle, once again, he's gonna get stuck in that combo. If he can get the body block off, it's gonna get the Cold Feet proc. And a little bit of slows, plus that Blade Fury, he's down once again. No, they're actually going to get the jug here. Oh, a little bit of pathing problems. Can she still get him? Where's the stun? Just stun. That was unfortunate.
PL dies bottom. That's so bad. That's so bad that the PL dies. Now that Centaur's got his Tranquil Boots, he's got level 5 or almost 6 already. That's a very, very poor swing for them. I don't know why those support heroes CP top. They didn't need to. The Bristleback is dead. Like that, then that's, you know, the
problem. They actually, I didn't check the range, but Venge could have easily gotten that kill on the Juggernaut. I think she might have been afraid of the Blade Fury dodge, but he had just used it, so.
Yeah, I think people overestimate how long the cooldown is on that spell now. It's so long compared to what it used to be. Mm-hmm. 34 seconds, even at level 2, which I think you need to get that skill to level 2 now just to make it usable. But still, 32 seconds is a very long time.
So if we do take a look at net worth, obviously not too far into the game yet. The Dire are ahead just by a bit after that successful start by the Radiant. I think after PL dying, Bristleback throwing it twice, actually, and they kind of gave up the advantage that they did have.
Yeah, I think they did a good job of getting the advantage early, but they didn't do a good job of really pressing the advantage.
Venge actually going to run right into the supports. With the Centaur ult, not going to be able to get the Cold Feet, but that extra damage coming out from the Shadow Fiend, and now Lina's in a poor position right now.
I think she's actually just dead.
Yep. Light Trick Array going to connect, and Bristle ran all the way from top.
They're getting moved around now. They're on the back foot. The Dire team is taking full advantage of the kills they've been able to get and the map control they've been able to get, not necessarily in that their heroes are very far into the Radiant side, but they have all of the, they're calling all the shots when it comes to ganks. The Radiant team just teeting around trying to save their heroes, but they can't even do it because the problem is all of them die very quickly. Yeah. Bristleback not at a high level. He has one level in Bristleback. I don't know if I would have gone for one level in Goo. He doesn't have any synergy with any of his team early on. But they have not a lot of heroes that can survive to, like, a three-man gank with, like, the Ancient Apparition and the Shadow Demon roaming around, and then any of the core heroes can kill them. That's a great roaming combo for this game specifically, because they have three heroes that can kill the hero that gets disrupted. Centaur can stun, and then uses Double Edge. Shadow Fiend has Triple Raise, and the Juggernaut has Blade Fury as well as just his auto attacks.
Sorry, I'm done.
I'm surprised the Radiant threw away their lead that bad, and the PL dying was just the cherry on top, and I don't like the builds that they're going for with these heroes. I think that getting Ringu Aquila is okay on the PL. I think that getting Bottle is more effective in a lot of situations than getting the Aquila, than just getting like a Ring of Basilius and the Bottle and using that to regen yourself up and then moving into a Vlad's.
You're talking about on the Bristleback?
No, on the Fanlancer.
Oh. It's better than the Ring of Aquila?
Yeah, I think that the Vlad's offers you way more than Aquila does, and the Bottle for 700 gold offers you a lot more regen and a lot more burst regen, which you need especially for your life.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna get something like Centaur, you're gonna get double-edged every, you know, like, not every time, but if you move up to the creep wave, you're gonna get double-edged. If you move up too far, you're gonna get stunned and then double-edged, and then you might die. And if you're not at full life all the time, it's really difficult. So
I don't know where this Phantom Lancer thinks he's going, but Centaur is gonna take a not actually too much.
I think he could have just ulted and killed him there twice.
Mm-hmm.
I think he actually can just ult and kill him. He only has 500 life. That was good dodge. The Centaur is not in trouble, but he can't get that kill. And they did take out the Shadow Fiend mid with the 3-man rotation, so that's good. This Bristleback is so far up again, he's taking a ton of damage off the tower and the Soul Catcher.
Wow, Jug.
Oh, he's level 6.
Okay. Yeah, he's still gonna die for it, though. I don't know if that was worth it for his life.
I think it's only worth it because the Bristleback's already so far down. Oh, they actually killed the Centaur when he ulted. Yeah. The Venge was there just in time. I was actually watching that. So, Phantom Lancer lives that time, but he's still having a rough time against the Centaur. Centaur is very high level now, and he's the same level as the Phantom Lancer, and it's hard for the Phantom Lancer to keep him out with Double Edge and with everything else going on.
Yeah, alright. Well, some people in chat saying a little bit of lag issues, guys. I have it running on a separate system. As far as that system goes, it seems stable. So, could just be connection between you and I. Try lowering the settings on your player just a bit, maybe. Hopefully it calms down. But up top, a little bit of a rotation from these support and cores, but that was kind of an awkward fight between both parties.
Missed a lot of spells, and then it just looked kind of weird going on. So I think that's okay, though. The Lina needs to get to farming, though, and she needs to not be doing these rotations where she doesn't get anything out of them.
I love this. I love the Soul Ring pickup on the Earthshaker. A lot of people just go for the Mana Boots Blink Dagger, but Soul Ring's such a good item.
I think that that's especially on that hero, but even on a lot of heroes. People stop picking up the Tranquil Soul Ring as much. I think it's very effective on a hero like this, that he doesn't need constant mana with the Mana Boots, because, I mean, the Mana Boots are good for heroes like a Tidehunter or someone like that, where he's always spamming Gank or Smashing. It doesn't cost a ton of mana, so if he got a Soul Ring, you know, he's spending 50 mana, but then he just wastes a bunch of it. The Urshaker, you're going to use the Mana Ring, and you're going to fissure instantly, and then burn a bunch of your mana right away. It's very efficient as compared to the Mana Boots. Steel's dead.
Urshaker's trying for the rotation, but
I think he actually might have been able to get out there if he just ran, but he tried to come in and kill the Centaur, which he couldn't have done because he has returned and he would have died anyway. He would have hit him. So.
Centaur, just about halfway to his blink already. He's killed PL twice so far, correct?
Yeah, he's doing a great job. I think he's getting so much out of this lane and making the Radiant pay for moving their supports around so much. The Shadow Fiend's dead mid, though. He seems...
The range on that spell still, even though they nerfed it, is incredible. Up top, Bristle, about to die. Not able to take out the Jug. Jug took a lot of damage there, but he's just gonna healing ward up and make it out.
Bristleback is playing too aggressive for my liking, and that was a little bit of my point when I said that he doesn't have a good time trading against these heroes, and he was up ahead and it looked good for him if he would have just kind of kept the status quo and out leveled this.
Fissure actually misses on this Centaur.
The Centaur's having a good time now. I don't actually think that they have a really difficult time killing him even if they actually trap him in.
Mm-hmm.
Either he has 1100 life and a stun that's going to stun all of PL's illusions and himself, so they have a pretty difficult time doing this, and the match is trying to wrap around, but she's.
I think the saving grace for this Radiant team right now is this Lina. She's doing very well.
Yeah, she's trading farm even with the Shadow Fiend, but the Shadow Fiend has died a couple times. I'd be interested to see what kind of build the Shadow Fiend goes for this game. It doesn't look like he's going duels with an Aquila. I think that Shadow Blade is probably a good decision this game. A lot of heroes you can blow up on the other team, including the Lina, which is a very prime target, and both of the Sword heroes. So, PL, honestly, even if he casts them out, if we can figure out which one is the non-illusion PL. So.
If he does go the Shadow Blade, he's going to have to follow it up, though, with a BKB, just because the Lina and Earthshaker.
Yeah, definitely. He definitely needs BKB at some point this game, but I really don't like the BKB first idea on any hero, because especially in a game like this where you're not going to default win late game, they have a Juggernaut, which is good mid game and a good hero definitely for fighting some of the support heroes and, you know, the Lina he's going to fighting, but the PL he's going to have a really difficult time against unless he gets very far ahead, so they need to be cautious of trying to go all in early and then losing, because then they just lose the game.
Yeah.
I think the Shadow Fiend's on par to do a lot of good things. He needs to itemize properly and make sure that he commits to something. I don't think the BKB first is the best option, like I said, just because I don't think he should be fighting that much, and he doesn't need it to go do that. I mean, even if he gets a BKB, he does a decent amount of damage. Oh, bottom
center. Yeah, he got out, though. He's alright. He's really tanky already.
In armor and 1200 life. It's pretty strong, you know. Very survivable.
Whereas on the other side of the map, this Bristle, level 8, he's already died, what, twice? Three times? Four times. Not
he's
having a good
actually better than I thought he would, but he is very far behind the Centaur. Even in just the amount of, like, not necessarily the numbers behind him, because I don't think that he's super far behind him in terms of, like, net worth or creep kills or anything like that, no, just, like, 600 gold, but in the amount of pressure that he's been able to apply to the map, he hasn't really been threatening this junk at any point, so.
Mid here. This Lina actually could die. No, the Shadow Fiend was not able to reach with the Rays.
A Rays too far. Was not able to convert it. Yeah, she's going for the Dual Scepter first, and I think she needs to focus on farming until she gets that, because she's
up top, this Jug might die here, but Bristle actually is going to get gone on. Unfortunately, I feel like he should have committed to the Jug. He's going to die before he gets the kill.
He should have just ran up into the tower. He was dead no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
They rotated or they didn't. This is very good. Oh, I shouldn't kill the Shadow Demon, that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
I think that if they reinitiate, they can actually go back on and kill the Shadow Demon.
Yeah, they have three. They have a stun, they have a swap, and they have all the Lina spells.
The Shadow Demon dude is dead anyway. Oh, the swap is on.
That was a decent swap, actually.
She's still trying to kill the Shadow Demon.
And
Shadow
she's actually... Oh, she... Wow. 14 health and...
Calculated.
Yeah, totally.
Calculated risks. Yeah, she really wanted to kill that Shadow Demon. She went for that nuke like three or four times trying to kill him.
Mm-hmm. So as it stands right now, Lina and PL standing on top of the net worth. Radiant in a decent position. I mean, they started to, you know, lose the advantage they gave, and then now kind of, you know, tossing the ball back and forth here in this game.
Yeah, I think both teams are suffering from a little bit of the same problem, which is that they're trying to fight too much, and it does look like the Shadow Fiend going for mech, which I think is a good build this game, too. If he wants to play a little bit more defensively and more steadily than the Shadow Blade.
It's kind of that awkward, he does so much damage, so it's like, do you want more damage and you'll be a glass cannon, or do you just go for the safer play? Mech, I don't know if... It's not really that powerful of an item on Ancient Apparition, obviously, because he's sitting so far back. And I feel like Shadow Demon needs more of the Force Staff. So...
Yeah. I think that he's really the only my carrier option this game. I think it's also pretty late for him to be getting it, though, is the main problem. He should be picking it up here in the next 30 seconds or so, but even 60-minute mech is, like, okay on Shadow Demon. He's clearing out these stats now, which is great that the Ancient Apparition stacked it, because otherwise he'd be really far behind. He just picked up, like, 600 gold killing these stacks, so... He was decently far behind, now he's right back up where Lina was. So that's
Centaur got his blink finally. 15-minute blink offlane, not too bad.
Yeah, he's got a bunch of and his boots and everything too, so not bad at all. He definitely has a big window where he can go on these heroes and make good use of the blink dagger, and that's really what you want to look for. It doesn't necessarily matter when he gets it, as long as the other heroes don't have their big stopping blocks for it, like a early BKB or something like that. So
that was actually... That was very good game sense by that Shadow Fiend, backing off right when the dust was popped. Lina's a little bit far away from her team.
Kill this guy.
She should be able to. Yep, he's dead. Ancient Apparition is also dead here.
Yeah, that was a waste of a Sendar ult, unfortunately. I think he didn't necessarily look, which you don't always do. You just see the triggers are getting gone on, and you just pop the ult, try and get him away. But unfortunately, he is unable to. And now SPL is getting a lot of space, which is good for him, because he was doing okay. But the hero obviously requires a lot of fire to really be a mean.
The only problem.
He's got a defuse on everything now, so.
Yeah, the only problem I see is that this Centaur has made a number of trips back to base just because he uses all of his mana and then runs away, and then uses all of his mana and runs back to base. So his experience is starting to dwindle a bit. I mean, he's still on top of the pack, but he could be so much farther ahead.
Yeah, I think he just needs to move around more now, and they need to leave the Shadow Fiend to kind of do his thing and have the Centaur kind of move around with these support heroes and try and get some of those kills with, like, Juggernaut Slayer or something like that, which the Juggernaut's gone for drums. I don't know if I super approve of that, but it seems like they're going to try and make something happen once they get this mech with Shadow Fiend, I think. They're going for a lot of early game centric items like that, where, you know, the Shadow Demon picked up, like, a Null Talisman and, like, some other random stuff, and they got the drums and the mech and everything, so. She's too fast.
Do you think the Shadow Fiend goes for a Yasha, or do you think he's still going to go that Shadow Blade after he went mech?
I think the logical choice after mech most of the time is Blink Dagger, but this game they already have pretty good initiation, so I don't know.
Initiation from the Centaur as well as the ultimate. This is good as dead as far as the Vengeance is considered. Shadow Fiend goes down, and I don't know if they can catch Venge. TP in rotation, but I don't know if they're going to get anything out of it. Just a weird, hey guys, I'm here.
Not so great of a trade. The Shadow Fiend probably should have just waited. They could have killed that Vendor without him.
They actually didn't. It was just the Centaur and the AA ult that killed him.
Yeah, so I don't think that needed to even come up in that position.
Bristle's getting a little bit too far up for comfort, but the Centaur might die here to a Light Strike Dragonslave. That is the case, and now Jug is coming in. Bristle's a little bit far up, leaving his back line to just die to this Jug right now. And actually, the Earthshaker was safe. Did Bristle end up dying in that?
No. He's Vanguard. Just okay. Towers, doesn't matter. he's kind of reached that point where he is definitely very effective against the Dire squad now with the Vanguard pickup and power treads. He already got 1500 life now. They gave him some time up top, and both of these offlaners got some space to get up like their base items. And for the Bristle back, that means that he can do a bunch of stuff like dive towers and do dumb stuff and not get punished for it. Most of the hero does. Runs around and spray schools everyone.
Phantom Lance are doing a lot better this game than he was doing last game. He has a lot more farm, almost finishing his Yasha already at just about 20 minutes probably.
Yeah, he's at good pace for farm this game, definitely more so than the last game we saw. He's definitely on pace with what you need to be getting to snowball with the hero and do really effective pushing and ganking with the hero, so.
Juggernaut started what looked like a Yasha, and then now he has 3k gold saved up. What do you think he's going for?
I think that Pentastyle is okay. I don't particularly like it because he's building like these little items, but if he just gets, like, even if it's not a mob, even if he just goes straight in for the Yasha and does that, or if he goes for, like, a Mjolnir or something like that, at least he can just burn someone down.
Actually, right now, missing a little bit of a fight. Centaur tried to get the kill on the Venge with the help of the AA ult, but he's going to give his life, and are they going to be able to get that Venge tick a few more? She's going to try to TP home for what? You're going to die.
She's dead.
Yep. Well does not go through that. Sorry about that, Venge.
They're pressuring the Shadow Fiend so much now, though, and it's getting really bad for him. So I think Radiant's in a very commanding lead now. They got the picks they needed after kind of a rocky start that they had, where they were kind of making the wrong moves and kind of throwing away a bit of the lead they had. The Lina still managed to pick up farm, and now they're making effective use of these three heroes, with the Bristleback kind of, but mostly the Lina, the Earthshaker, and the Ventral Spirit have been just moving around in the opponent's jungle and just killing anyone who comes in there.
PL being able to push this tier 2 down bot. They do have a fort, so they might be able to deny it. And in comes the Centaur. PL, you might want to get out there, buddy. Once again, Lina with the haste rune, looking for the Ancient Apparition. Oh. Yep. Unfortunate for these supports, like I said, they're so squishy.
Yeah, and that is a byproduct of the Lena getting ahead so early and being able to kind of just run around and do this. Like, she shouldn't be able... Lena should not be able to go into the opponent's team jungle and just wander around until she's a support hero most of the time. You should be able to kind of pick her up before she gets into that position. But their cores are so far behind that who's going to go fight her? The only person who doesn't die to that combo is Centaur Baby, I think. I mean, he still might actually die to it. So, I mean, everyone else is going to instant die to that because the Shadow Fiend has his mech and that could help him if he can actually get it off, but usually he won't be able to, so...
Yeah, I think Centaur might survive just with that magic resistance.
Yeah, I think he might do okay, but even regardless, like so basically you have to have your Centaur guarding every single one of your heroes in the jungle, and that's not how you want to play Dota.
No.
You want to be able to...
Juggernauts...
You want to be able to control the lead.
Juggernauts go in the Battle Fury that you called early on.
I don't like it. I think that it's... okay, but it's too late now. Like, he's already gotten drums and stuff, and it's 22 minutes in, and what's his battle fear really going to do for him? He's still going to get burned down by the PL illusions regardless of what. They just missed that combo. That's unfortunate. Great play by the Lina. And
oh, nice.
Earthshaker, who now has a Blink Dagger and Tranquil Boots.
And Juggernaut trapped in here. He's just going to try to TP out. He's going to make it, but... oh, nice. Nope. That was an awkward swap.
Swap PL illusion. That was a good effort, he just didn't make it in time for the vision to actually swap the Juggernaut out.
But this is easily going to be a Radiant top top tower.
Yeah, I think the Dire has to play very well now to come back from this deficit. They are they're in a rough spot. Earthshaker's got Blink, as you just saw in that last fight. He's 3-0-10, doing an excellent job this game of just being involved in what his team's doing and getting farm out from that way. I think that's the best way to play Earthshaker, is just to... not necessarily get left alone to farm your Blink Dagger, but you want to just help your team set up those initiations and do a really good job of helping everyone else get ahead. And it definitely puts you ahead as well.
As far as vision goes right now, though, the Dire have decent vision. They just... I don't know if they have it in the right spots, because there are still some areas that Lena can sneak by.
They have decent vision, but the problem is, even if the heroes come into their jungle, like, what are they going to do about it? Like, what are they going to do about Earthshaker and Lena just walking into the jungle? Unless they bring all five heroes to go fight them, and then make sure that they get on them, which is difficult with the Lena with the Yule Scepter and the Earthshaker with the Blink Dagger. They have to actually get out of it and start fighting them, and the only person who can do that is the Centaur, and they just have to commit a lot to, like, these fights, and that, like I said before, that's not really how you want to play. You don't want to have to commit every single one of your heroes to stopping the other team from coming into your jungle. It's a rough position to play from.
I don't think the Dire are out of it just yet. However, this Jug Battle Fury, I don't see doing anything extremely good. Like, I don't see it solving the Lena issue.
No, it definitely doesn't solve the Lena issue. I don't think anything for them is going to solve the Lena issue other than not getting killed by Lena for a while. The Shadow Fiend's dead now. Oh, she lifted a Battle Fury. Never mind. That beast still might be dead.
You can see some Snot as well as a Laguna Blade down. Earthshaker just waiting on one more Fissho. Unfortunately, it's a long time away, but a few right clicks and some needles. And that's all you need.
It's got Crimson now, so they can just dive whatever they want. And it's not even just him that can't die. He can just Crimson everyone, and then they can just dive all the tier 3 towers they want. But like you said, they do not have an answer for the Lena issue right now, which is that she can kill any one of their heroes at will.
Yeah, I didn't even see she picked up the eggs already. Holy crap. I think an Omni Slash would kill her, but that's if he can catch her alone and not with any of her team, which Earthshaker and Venger, like, sticking to her like glue, because why not?
Yeah, they might as well. As long as the lead is moving around in the jungle, as long as they just leave this, and even the PL doesn't even need to farm anymore, honestly. He's almost got Mana Style already at 25 minutes. If he just goes with his team, he can just pick up these kills, and they have an answer for him either, so it's pretty difficult for the Dire right now to get anything going.
Centaur being slowed down by a bunch of Snot. He misses the stun. Nice Fissure combo, and they might be able to clean up this Jug. He tries to Blade Fury out with a wand, gonna be able to get out. They might chase down this AA. Lean's his Yules. Jug going in, trying to clean up what he can, but nothing. He doesn't even have a Blade Fury to follow it up with.
They just don't have options that they need to take these heroes down. If the Shadow Fiend would have gotten more farm early on and gotten past his mechanism, I think he would have had a better shot. And if the Juggernaut would have gone for something more damage focused, because the problem now is he doesn't have any damage, and even if he gets gone, and he still dies. So, like, why have drums? If you're just going to die when you get gone anyway, then what's the point of getting them? You want to get drums to kind of beef up early on and be able to fight, but at this point, you might as well have Mask of Madness, because either way, he's just going to die as soon as Lina Yules him anyway.
I think the biggest issue, though, here is that when if the Dire said, okay, we're going to initiate on you, it's just always someone gets initiated on, and then it's the, do we run or do we try to fight? If we try to fight, we're going to lose at least three people.
Yeah, and that's playing from, you know, a position of submission, essentially, where, you know, the other team is basically free to do whatever they want, and you're just free to just sit there and do whatever they want. I mean, you can't really fight back against them. They're way too far ahead. If you look at the net worth graphs, the only person who's above
oh my gosh.
You know, the Venge is twice as much as any of the support heroes, and the Earthshaker's got more farm than the Centaur now, so it's pretty brutal when it comes to just the overall net worth, and Pyong and Lina are just leads ahead of them now, and both of those heroes make good use of that farm at this point in the game.
Has Lina died yet?
She got ganked once, I think. Two deaths, yeah.
I feel like if they can kill the Lina and put it on someone like Shadow Fiend, they might get something out of that gold. But like, if he can get his BKB, but then he doesn't have a blink.
Yeah, I mean, he can get BKB, and I think he is getting it with the Ogre Club, but oh, they're actually in the smoke and see if they can get something. If they can catch him in the Roche pit, they might have a good shot at taking the fight, but the Venge very smartly is going to die for her team. Oh, no.
Unfortunate miss by Centaur. She's just going to hold the line while here comes Lina. Oh, wow. What a wombo combo coming out right now from the Dire team. Jug's going to try to clean something up, and actually he does a lot of damage here.
Yeah, they stacked up on top of that Blade Fury. I don't know if they actually knew they had Battle Fury, but that was a very poor stacking play, but they still win this fight.
Mm-hmm. Just by the skin of their teeth, if that AA ult would have landed on a bit more, I didn't even see it land on too many, and he's gonna die as well.
I have to think that they just didn't see that the Juggernaut had Battle Fury, because they were all just standing right on top of each other as soon as the Kicker went in, so they all took all the clean damage, and that was what made that fight even close. They would have just smashed them if they didn't attack up like that, so I still think that they're in a very good position. They're trying to vote right now. I don't actually think they can, because none of these heroes can tank it. Bristleback has no life.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, maybe they can, actually, because the Bristleback does have Crimson, doesn't it?
If AA actually ults right when he gets up, he might be able to pick off all three of them. Wait, what level is he? Oh, it's only a level 1. He might be able to get Bristle, obviously. Venge, actually, too. Ulti, AA.
It's fantastic for them.
Yep, here it comes.
He's off, though. He's going to get hit by the shield.
Nope. If that fight would have went well for the Dire, that would have been their in back into the game, but unfortunately just another slip-up.
Well, the problem now is that this Shadow Fiend's gone for this Mech Bull. He doesn't have kind of like the surprise factor of like a Shadow Blade or something where he can get in and, you know, maybe they don't suspect the Invis, they don't have a ward down or something like that, and he gets in and gets off a sweet Requiem and kills two heroes at once, you know, something like that where they can really turn the tide. He's got a mechanism, and mech's great for just doing normal Shadow Fiend stuff, going in, hitting heroes, using your raises, and if you're, you know, on even footing, it's great because you have good survivability and everything, but from behind, it's very difficult for him to make good use of all of his spells and all of his abilities.
Where did Jug use these? Light Strike, oh wow, just deletes the Jug and almost takes out the Shadow Fiend, too. Lina might want to back up. She's in a bit. Oh, no, here comes the rest of her team. Both Centaur and Shadow Fiend in a bit of a Pernicadim. Nice BKB into a Requiem, but that's it. He doesn't have anything after that.
Oh, four seconds.
Stun on the Centaur, and down goes the Shadow Fiend, down goes the Centaur, and the Shadow Demon. I didn't see where Jug died, but
he died to Lina at the beginning.
Oh, yeah, that's right, that's right.
Yeah, and PL's dominant performance for Radiance. The one good thing I saw was that the Lina got stunned, and the Ancient Apparition and Centaur Double Edge were about to land on her, as well as some Shadow Demon poison, and the Venge pushed her out of the way, and then she got off a Dragon Slave and killed two people. So it's just, they're just so far behind now, it's just so difficult for them to do anything.
I don't know if I see anything. I think this is going to be double racks right here.
They're so far behind. It's very... They don't have a big comeback ult, even, because the Shadow Fiend just uses Requiem, and he has no souls, so...
They have a Blade Fury on the Jug, but even still, what does that do?
you might be able to pick up one or two, but yeah, they still are in a rough spot and they still probably lose. I mean, Riddick, it's pretty much a repeat of the last game we watched. Actually, they could just back up, go to the C1, get some mana, and then just roll out top lane and just win. Mm-hmm. There's nothing that the...
Was the Aegis popped at all? No, it was not. It's still on Alina. She has a Silver Edge.
I think that's... That build is, like, insane on that hero, too. It's such a good build to go for the Silver Edge afterwards, because all of these heroes... Like, that for one, disables Jug's crit. It disables Shadow Fiend's passive, which is a great armor degen.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, even without that, it does 200 extra damage. It's like another extra nuke for her when she hits someone. Does 225 damage or whatever it is. It's like a crazy amount of damage just for hitting someone from 600 range.
It also gives her that exactly what she's been doing. Running around and just killing people. She doesn't even have to use it for that nuke. She just needs it for that invisible initiation.
Yeah, that's very, very good in the hero. And it gets what she needs to, too. And I think that's probably one of the most well-rounded items that they added in the new patch, because it costs a decent chunk of money, but the build-up's good, and for a lot of these heroes, like Lina, getting an extra Sanjo without using an extra item slot is awesome, because it gives her, like, a decent amount of life and some more survivability to an otherwise very squishy hero.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's sitting at 19 right now, where's Centaur? Centaur's only at 15.
Yeah, she's so far ahead now, too.
Quite unfortunate for this Dire team. I think, honestly, this Shadow Fiend, even though the way he's built, he does do a lot of damage with his nukes and the armor reduction. I just think it's the same thing we saw last game with the TA. It's just too much survivability and not enough, like, presence in the team fight.
Yeah, like I said about the mech, you know, it's great if you're playing on even footing and if you're trying to take even fights with the other team. It's a great burst of health and a great survivability tool for the Shadow Fiend, but if you're playing from behind, it doesn't really offer him anything more than you'd be getting with any other item. It's not like a Shadow Blade or even like a quick SNY or something like that, where he'd actually be getting some more physical damage out of it. And even if he does get physical damage, the problem now is that the Bristleback of the Crimson Garden has had it, and what is the Shadow Fiend going to do about that? That's an extra 50 damage he doesn't do every time he hits someone, which is a huge deal.
Nice swap. They actually had vision. That was a weird disruption. What happened there?
She got hit while she was forcing.
Oh, okay. Bristle's running in, just hears the party, man. He's just frontlining. He knows exactly what he's here for, and they can't really do anything. Lita's going to go after this Jug. Unfortunately, he gets the Blade Fury, but they can just take this tower.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, they're so far behind. The option is either they burn everything on Bristleback and maybe kill him because he's got a heart and a Crimson Guard, and it's still really difficult.
And Jug getting caught out right now. The Omni Slash actually put him in a very poor position on top of a Fissure and a Light Strike. With the Laguna Blade, down he goes, and Bristle is just going to push them all the way while the rest of his team cleans up the wrecks. PL's playing Objective Gaming. Off goes the Requiem, does decent damage, actually, but she still has an Aegis. Oh, no, she doesn't. She already died with it. Or did it? It must have went down. It must have went down during the fight. That was an almost. That was an almost gotcha. But even still, they got Mega Creeps. That's game.
Even if she dies, it's pretty relevant to the fact that they're just... The PL is so far ahead, too. It's not just that Lina's the problem. Is the PL has a Scotty and a Man style in 35 minutes. Like, it's pretty brutal.
Alright, well, that's GG, guys. Once again, I have been Trips, joined by my buddy Walrus. And I do not know if there is going to be another game tonight. There might be, but if not, make sure you follow the channel so you can see when I go live again, if it's going to be tomorrow. But thanks a lot for sticking around, and we'll see you in the next game.